A very good afternoon to each one of you.
Welcome all to this one-day webinar on PCOS, that is polycystic ovary syndrome or disorder, symptoms, causes, and treatment.
By the Woman Development Cell under the aegis of RUSA. We at HSEE are celebrating Women's Week. And as a part of celebrations, Woman Development Cell has organized a series of programs for college students, school and college teachers. It is said that a woman's health is her capital. The health status of women directly reflects the health status of the nation.
The concept of women's health has become a major concern today with the kind of lifestyle we all live. Diseases and disorders of the female reproductive system threatens the physical and emotional health of many women. PCOS or PCOD is a common complaint these days that we get to hear from our female students. These students undergo a lot of stress as they have to undergo a series of examinations, tests, and not understanding what exactly are they going through. Due to this, we felt it was essential that we create an awareness about this commonly occurring disorder among women. To help understand this syndrome or disorder, we have with us Dr. Maitri Dhopade, a very senior gynecologist and obstetrician. Dr. Dhopade completed MBBS from Topiwala National Medical College in 1990 and then completed her MD in obstetrics and gynecology from Nair Hospital in 1993. Madam worked as assistant professor with Rajawadi Hospital before starting private practice in 1996 at her own Shushrut Maternity and Gynecological Hospital. Madam is an acclaimed gynecologist in the western suburbs of Mumbai. And it is indeed an honor to have Madam with us today. On behalf of Gujarat Research Society's Hansraj Jeevandas College of Education, our management, our principal, Dr. Anita Swami, Madam, staff, students, and all the participants, I, Dr. Vaishali Savan, extend a warm welcome to you, Dhopade Madam, and I now request you to commence with the session.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, yeah. Madam. Good afternoon. Madam, just a minute. Please, if you have any queries, students, yeah. All the participants, in case you have any queries, please put up on the WhatsApp group or you may put up on the Zoom chat. Okay, our faculty would pick up the questions from there and then we pose those questions to Dr. Dhopade. Yes, madam, you may begin now.
Yeah.
The platform is totally yours.
Yes. Hello, good afternoon to all. I my sincere thanks to Principal Ma'am, Dr. Anita Swami, and her organizing team, especially Dr. Vaishali Savan for inviting me for this webinar and giving me this platform to share my thoughts on this health issue. Do you know that almost 1 in 5 women suffer from PCOS? It is a gynec epidemic. When I was studying in medical college around 30 years back, we read about it in our textbooks, and seeing a patient of PCOS was a rarity. Since last 20 years, I used to see, hello, is there any problem? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you.
Yeah. Since last 20 years, I used to see around 10 patients of PCOS in a month. But now I see 10 patients of PCOS in a day. This is a very alarming situation. Let us see what is this PCO, PCOS or PCOD. All are same. We say patient is of PCO when the problem is limited to the ovary. But when the multiple systems of the body are involved, it is called as a PCOS or polycystic ovarian syndrome. Now, how will you know that anyone is suffering from PCOS? If the patient is getting irregular periods, like she's not getting her periods, but cycles are not regular, like every 2 or 3 months she bleeds, or when she gets the periods they're very heavy and prolonged, or if the patient is gaining weight, or if there is a difficulty in losing weight, you may suspect that she's having PCOS. Some patients, they may complain of excess hair loss, or there may be hair growth on the face, chin, or on the tummy. This is due to the excess male hormone, like called testosterone, which is produced because of the hormone imbalance. Some patients may complain of acne or oily skin. Some patients, they may have a difficulty in falling asleep. There may be sleep apnea or snoring. Patient will have a daytime sleeplessness, or she may complain of fatigue during daytime. She may show symptoms of like anxiety or depression. Now, what is the reason for the PCOS? It is due to the hormonal imbalance. Normally, our body has a biological rhythm, which is balanced beautifully by our hypothalamus, pituitary, ovarian axis. Hypothalamus is a small gland which is situated in the brain, which controls the pituitary function, which in turn controls our ovary function. And which in each menstrual cycle, which on average of 20 to 30 days in a normal healthy female, one egg is slowly grows in size, and when it turns of the particular size around 20 millimeter, it ruptures. And this process is called ovulation, which happens approximately on the 14th day of the cycle. But when this process gets delayed or it doesn't happen, then the egg, which is slowly growing in size, remains like that in the ovary, forming a cyst. Over the period of few months, multiple cysts are seen in the ovary, either one or both of the ovaries. This cyst produce excessive hormones called androgens, which produce body changes. Then the patient doesn't get period on time, and they cause thickening of the lining of the uterus. And hence, when there is a delay in the periods, it causes excessive bleeding or for prolonged duration, when there is a breakdown of this lining. But then why this happens? What is the reason for this? Whether it is genetic? Whether it is genetic, but it is seen that patient's mother or grandmother, they have not suffered from this condition during their lifetime. So maybe genes were there, but they were not expressed. Then what is the reason why it is expressed now in today's generation? Maybe there are a few reasons, like, you know, sedentary lifestyle, wrong eating patterns, or maybe poor sleep. Or it may be excessive use of chemicals in our day-to-day life, like use of plastic, or use of aluminum foil to carry our food, use of pesticides, home cleaners. It all can trigger PCOD. It is a new disease. Your mom and grandmom didn't have it. Our maid servant, who is from the lower socioeconomic strata, also doesn't have it. So think, what is the reason that there is a sudden surge of these cases? Now the next topic. How you diagnose PCOS? By symptoms you can diagnose. If the patient is having irregular periods, she is not bleeding regularly, or if it's a heavy flow, or the patient is having excess weight gain, or there is a hair fall or acne, then you may suspect that girl maybe is having PCOS. Then you do sonography. If you are suspecting, you have to confirm the diagnosis. So you do sonography. In sonography, you can see the both ovaries or one of the ovaries enlarged, is bulky in size, and is showing multiple cysts. Then you do certain hormone tests to diagnose PCOS. You do lipid profile if the patient is overweight, do sugar testing, and do hormonal, do vitamin levels. Usually these PCOS girls, they are deficient in vitamin D or vitamin B12. And also you do serum insulin level, because there is an insulin resistance in PCOS. So the insulin levels are reached. That is a cause, and that is a cause of alarm, because usually these patients, they'll end up in diabetes in future. Now, how you manage PCOD? Once you are diagnosed, how you will treat PCOD? What advice will you give to the girl who is suffering from PCOS? Mainstay of treatment, you say, is diet and exercise. We should eat healthy, freshly prepared food. You buy vegetables which are organic, local, and seasonal. Avoid processed food which is loaded with preservatives and chemicals. go low on dairy. Nowadays we say, if you consume a lot of milk and dairy products, which are loaded with estrogens, because these cows from where we get the milk, cows and buffaloes, they are injected with hormones. So this milk is loaded with estrogen and oxytocin, and which causes these hormonal imbalances. So goes low on dairy. Also, there should be intelligent mix of carbs, proteins, and fats. Prefer plant-based diet. I don't say can avoid, we become vegan, but at least prefer plant-based diet. Eat carbs which are good in fibers, like jowar, bajri, nachne, which are rich in fibers and antioxidants, and they have a low glycemic index. Eat healthy fats such as ghee, olive oil, and seed oil like coconut. Avoid saturated fats like dalda and margarine. Eat proteins on daily basis like dals, sprouts, egg also you can have on daily basis. Then consume certain seeds like chia seeds, pumpkin seeds, which are rich in antioxidants. Eat nuts, handful of nuts like almonds or pistachios. Avoid cashew nuts as far as possible because they are rich in calories. Then cooking method, that also helps, you know, to control the weight gain. Cook in an iron or in a copper vessel. Avoid overcooking, which destroys all the nutrients. Avoid repeated frying in the same oil as it turns rancid and is full of toxins. Drink plenty of water every day, at least 2 to 2.5 liters every day. And what will be your diet pattern once you get up in the morning? You can have in the morning, you can have a methi seed water or jeera water that will increase your metabolism. You can have a lemon water or cinnamon water. You can also take apple cider vinegar with a lukewarm water, which helps in the weight loss. Have a mindful eating. You know, eat small portions and eat when you are hungry and not in front of TV or with mobile in your hands. And do intermittent fasting if possible, you know, which is helpful to increase the insulin level in the body because there is an insulin resistance and also helps in the weight loss. And what is this intermittent fasting? You have two meals in a day. Like morning, if you have your lunch, you should avoid breakfast in this intermittent fasting. You have a lunch at around 1 o'clock. Then you have a next meal at around 8 o'clock. In between these two meals, you don't eat anything. When you break your fast, you can have your meal or you can have your food over a period of 1 hour. After the last meal, if you have your last meal at 8 o'clock, then next day morning, again, you have your next meal at 1 o'clock. You try this for at least a month. Definitely will see a weight loss and a good result. Easy availability of the food and high calorie content of your junk food, they are reasons for this obesity and epidemic and PCOD. Now let us talk about exercise. Incorporate exercise in daily life. Keep moving, don't sit at one place for more than 15 minutes. Take stairs, walk short distances whenever possible, or rickshaws for short distances. Do your own errands. Non-exercise active thermogenesis is a new concept. What is this called? NEAT, non-exercise active thermogenesis. Which shows that any small activity like washing your own teacup or plate, standing while talking on a mobile or working on a laptop burns calories, which over the year is a significant in number. Daily exercise of 40 minute duration in any form like walking, jogging, running, yoga will do. Walking in sunlight helps you to overcome vitamin D deficiency, which is very common in PCOD patient. Happy hormones are released during exercise, like dopamine and serotonin. Mix of cardio and weight training helps in muscle buildup and bone strengthening. Effective diet and physical activity can reverse PCOD. Stress reduction is also very important in PCOD. That is one of the major causes of PCOD. So how you reduce the stress? stress by doing meditation. Most importantly, you should sleep on time and wake up on time. Good night sleep of 6 to 7 hours is essential for a hormone balance. Nowadays, students, they remain awake till late at night on the mobile. Some students are studying, some are on the WhatsApp or Facebook or Instagram. They sleep very late by 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock, and then they have to wake up early. So sleep is disturbed. Night sleep is very essential because that melatonin hormone, which is released from the brain at night, it controls our ovulation cycle. So when the night sleep is not there, the good quality sleep is disturbed, then it causes PCOD. So you should try to sleep on time. By 11:30, you should get to the bed and sleep for 6 hours minimum. Then you should take vitamin supplements like vitamin D3, B12 if needed. If you are anemic, take iron, calcium also. Consult your gynec for the cycle control. You may need medicines like metformin or myo-inositol to increase your insulin sensitivity. Those patients who are married and who want to get pregnant, they may need treatment. One more thing is to start by using tiny habits. So if your goal is 1 hour of exercise, start by doing it for 10 minutes daily, gradually increasing over the period of time as your body gets adapted to it. Don't rush into things. If you do exercise vigorously for 7 to 10 days, then you may not do it, able to do it for another 1 month. So it is better to go slow and steady. Similarly, if you are consuming junk food daily, reduce it by consuming it only once in a week. Similarly, doing meditation, start with 2 minutes daily and increase it to 20 minutes. Reduce the use of mobile, switch it off 1 hour before you sleep. So go slow and steady and go tiny to begin with and gradually scale up. So in the end, take home message is be happy, active, and eat fresh, healthy food. Avoid junk food, get proper sleep, avoid stress, stay hydrated. Thanks for listening to my talking and hope it will be helpful to you. Thanks a lot.
That is very, very useful insights that you gave us about our lifestyle, change in lifestyle to be made by us. Yeah. And madam, there are many, many questions for you. Should we take up all those questions?
Yes.
Yeah. Because there would be specific questions from to prevent such syndrome, or maybe there may be some who may be showing some symptoms.
Yeah.
So there are questions. So let's take those questions, ma'am.
Yes.
I'll read out those questions to you.
Okay.
And ma'am, just give me a minute.
WhatsApp, Arella.
Dr. Manjeet?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah,
would you like, you please take up the Zoom chat questions. I'll take up the WhatsApp.
Sure. Thank you very much, Dr. Maitri Dhople. That was such an insightful talk. Yeah. So clearly you have brought, in the limelight, the kind of lifestyle that we are leading, which has led to this sudden surge that we see in, especially the adolescent PCOS. Yes. Yeah, there are questions for you, madam. I would like to read them out. The very first question is, madam, you have said that weight loss is good for keeping PCOS at bay.
Yeah.
But if one has food only twice a day, won't that lead to weight gain? If you skip meals or you have huge gaps between, won't this lead to weight gain? I'm a little confused here. Could you more light on?
This is a new concept. It's called intermittent fasting. If you remain hungry for a long duration of time, right? Then the fat which is accumulated in the body over a period of time, it burns. When you eat frequently, like previously used to say, you should have a small frequent meals. So what happens, when you eat something, body produces insulin, to digest that thing. And that excessive insulin production, it causes exhaustion of the pancreas if it releases repeatedly, and that causes fat deposition. But if you remain hungry for a long time, and if you eat like only twice a day meals, then what happens when you eat? During that time only the insulin is increased, and that causes fat melting. So when you remain hungry, like previously it's the malnourished, you know, when there was a famine, they used to lose weight because they used to have meals only twice. Nowadays we eat very frequently, and that is not necessary. So that calorie burn is not there. You are not doing enough physical activity to burn those calories. So eating that frequently is not essential. You know? Even if you do 24 hours fast once in a week, that is good. You know, in like certain cultures or religious things, they do fasting, you know, for 24 hours. So that helps.
Yes, I'm sure, madam.
It's difficult to follow, but once in a while, you can try that, you know.
I'm sure you have satisfied the query of this person. The next question is, how to deal with fatigue and depression because of PCOS?
Yeah, this fatigue and depression is mainly stress related, you know, because of the hormonal changes. Usually the patient is deficient in vitamins, vitamin D3 and B12. So she should get her vitamin levels checked. And if they're very low, she should take the supplements as soon as possible, you know. Usually the vitamin D is very low. That causes changes in the brain. Sometimes it leads to depression. Similarly, vitamin B12. So they should take supplements. They should eat healthy, fresh fruits and vegetables and sprouts and increase their protein intake. So that will help them to fight the depression. And they should sleep on time. You know, that is also very essential.
Yes, madam.
Yeah.
The next question is, when periods are delayed by 3 to 4 days. Mm-hmm. Can we say that it's a symptom of PCOS?
No. If it is delayed only by 3 to 4 days, that's okay. Because some patients, they have a little irregular cycle since their period starts, what you call as menarche. If it is delayed by few days, it doesn't matter. If it is delayed significantly over a period of time, like by 2 months, 2.5 months, then you have to worry, and it's better to show to the gynecologist.
The next question is the massage therapy helpful in reducing excessive fat and helps in weight loss?
No, I don't agree with that. Massage therapy, maybe it will shift the fat from one point to another, but I don't think it helps to melt the fat. I don't agree with that. No, that excess fat you have to burn. No, by doing exercises and dieting. It is a stubborn fat, you know, it's just a shifting the fat from here to there. It won't help.
Right. Like it has been said, no gain without pain in case of weight loss.
Yeah.
So you really don't achieve any weight loss without. The next question, madam, for you is how to keep track of the period dates when having PCOS?
Okay. Either you can, on mobile, there is an app, you know, you can keep a track of that entry and exit. You will know when you get the period, you entry, menstrual calendar, you can maintain. And girls, they are quite aware of this app, you know, they have the app on the mobile where you can say how many days she bled, the next cycle, and 3 to 4 cycles track you should keep. If you are getting one month, 10 days duration, you're getting periods and bleeding for 4 to 5 days, that is perfectly normal. But if the girl is not getting the periods for 2 months, then 3 months, or if she's bleeding excessively for 10 days, 15 days, and then the spotting continues for long duration, then she should show to the gynecologist. You know? She should take the treatment for that. Some girls, they wait on it. Our parents also suggest, you know, you wait, just don't show to the doctor. It is better to show to the doctor and confirm what is the reason for this. It may be stress related also.
The cysts in the ovary go on their own after we lose weight? That's the question by Shruti Parab. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If there is a good weight loss and if the patient is eating healthy food and following a healthy lifestyle, most of the times the cycles become regular and then the cyst automatically disappears. So no need to worry. No, but patient should significantly lose weight. That will help.
Yeah, there's a question. I'm sorry, I did not name, dear participants, I earlier did not name you when I posed the questions. Barkha Bale has posed this question. Does taking iron supplements result in weight gain?
No, not at all. This iron, usual iron deficiency is common in PCOD because they have bleeding pattern, like they bleed very heavily or they pass clots also. So it's better to take iron supplements if they're anemic. There's no harm with that. They won't gain with iron supplements.
This question is by Gunjan Soni. Before the 5 to 6 days of menstrual cycle, I frequently have to visit the washroom. Is this a probable symptom that women face before periods?
Before the menses, she gets the urge.
Yes.
Achha. And there is a pain also accompanying with that, or just a...
No, she has not mentioned that. She just has to visit.
I do get it. Like 3-4 days earlier than that, I do have the pain, like normal pain. Okay. Backache and stuff, yeah.
Achha. We get the urge, frequent urge. It can be because of the early urine infection also. So drink lots of water and just observe. If it recurs again, just get your urine routine done to rule out any infection. It can be a sign of early urine infection, which is very common.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Priyanka has this question, which madam actually has addressed, but maybe you can reiterate once again.
Yeah.
In your talk, you had spoken about the different ways of exercising. Priyanka says, ma'am, you said that walk after 15 minutes, but nowadays we are sitting in front of the laptop for long hours. Any other ideas of doing exercise?
See, if she cannot get up every 15 minutes, then you can do a morning walk if possible for 1 hour. Or evening walk also, if she doesn't get any time. At least 1 hour daily walk is essential. Any form of activity. Not just walking, I'm saying. If you're sitting near laptop for a long time, when you get up for a lunch time, that time you can walk for 15 minutes. When you go out, then take a small walk. Don't travel by rickshaw as far as possible. Nowadays, I understand you are sitting in front of laptop from morning to evening. No, that is the problem. So evening, you can go out and take a walk. That is possible, I feel.
Absolutely. And as madam had said, maybe you can stand up and, you know, attend your lectures, Priyanka, from time to time, instead of continuously sitting, as you mentioned about neat, ma'am.
Yeah,
Gunjan has this question, ma'am. She said, I tried jeera water, but it delayed my menstrual cycle. What to do?
No, actually, I don't think it is responsible for your delayed cycle. Sometimes once in a year, if your cycle is delayed, no need to worry as such. Sometimes the ovulation is delayed in a particular cycle. It may be stress related also. So no need to worry. You can continue jeera water. It is good for health.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. There's no actual correlation between. Yeah. Barkha has this question, ma'am. Is it possible to eliminate PCOS completely, or is it a lifetime disease?
It is actually a lifestyle disease, not a lifetime disease. It's a lifestyle disease. So I think if anybody controls diet and do regular exercise, it will be under control. You cannot eliminate it fully, but it remains under control for a long duration of time. And sometimes it reverses also. I've seen a few patients with significant weight loss. They become all right, and they got married and they conceived also beautifully. There was no problem with that. So it can be reversed.
Yes. So yes, with correction in our lifestyle, definitely we can reverse it. Jyoti Kumari has this question. How much time does it take to get completely cured from PCOS?
There is no complete cure as such. As I told you, changing lifestyle, reducing stress and sleeping on time and good habits, that will cause or it will halt the progression of PCOS. You can't reverse it completely, you know. But usually, over the period of time, she starts getting regular cycles. If she loses weight, she will get regular cycles. So there won't be any issue. Most of the times, what happens, you know, girls, they do diet and exercise for a short while. They reduce weight. Then again, they go back to their old lifestyle. You know, so whatever reversal has happened, it turns back. And again, they start getting irregular cycles. So it is a long-term goal. It's not a short-term goal.
Yes, very, very true.
Yeah.
This is a question by Deepthi Puthran. She says, ma'am, is it possible that a woman has PCOS when they have all the symptoms you mentioned, but they have drastic weight loss instead of weight gain?
Okay. Instead of weight
instead
loss,
of gaining weight, they have weight loss.
There is a concept called a lean PCOS. Lean PCOS. So girls are lean, they are underweight or they are normal weight, but still they have a PCOS. So I think it is because of the stress, excess stress, irregular eating pattern. They may not be overweight, they may be normal weight or they may be on the lesser side, but still they are having irregular cycles. Because this maturity of the hypothalamus pituitary axis, it happens at night, you know, when they sleep regularly on time. These girls, most of the time, they remain awake till late. They are on mobile and gadgets. So that may be the reason, because that melatonin, which is released at night, is not released properly. So that causes certain changes, hormonal changes in the body. So ovulation is not happening. So previously, we used to see a fat girl with a PCOD. But nowadays, we see a normal weight or lean girl with a PCOD. So basically, it is not related just to the weight. It related to stress also.
Very true. Very true. This is, ma'am, if periods are getting delayed by 15 to 20 days.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, one, just a moment. Yeah, that's just the question.
Yeah.
If the periods are getting delayed by 15 to 20 days, would that also come, or is it only if it is for a few months, 1 or 2 months?
If it is just 1 or 2 months in a year with no other changes like increase in body weight or hair fall or acne, then no need to worry, I feel. You know, if it is occurring more frequently with the increased weight gain, or if she's getting heavy flow, after 1 and 2 months she gets the period, but the flow is heavy or is for longer duration, then it's better to show to a doctor. If it's a normal flow, after 1.5 months she gets the period, but the period is of normal duration, there's no need to worry.
Yes, I think your question is answered. This is Gunjan's question again. I am Jain, madam. I try eating by 7:30 p.m. and my morning breakfast is at about 10 a.m. after exercise. Is this okay?
If your weight is normal according to your height, then continue whatever suits you the best. You know, if your periods are regular, if weight is proper, no need to do any intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting only for those people who are gaining abnormal weight, or they are difficult in losing weight, or they're getting irregular periods. Then only should go for intermittent fasting. For everybody, it is not advisable.
Yes, yes, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Ma'am, there's another question, which is quite long. I tried Jeera water, but it delayed.
The same girl.
Just a moment. Can you give some more details on intermittent fasting?
Intermittent fasting? Yeah. Intermittent fasting is a concept like you should have your meals 2 times in a day. You start with 2 times in a day. Gradually, you can go for a 24 hours fast, you know, once in a day meal. So in 24 hours, in this one, 2 meals a day plan, if you have your 1 meal in the morning or in the afternoon by 1 o'clock, then second meal, you can have it around 8 o'clock. After the second meal, you should have a 16 hours fast. Like if you have your last meal at 8 o'clock, 8 p.m., then you can have a next meal the next morning after skipping breakfast. So 8 to 8, 12 hours, another 4 hours. So around 12 o'clock, you can have your first meal of the day. So 12 and 8 will be suitable for you, anybody. 12 and 8. Understood? So after second meal, you should have a 16 hours fasting. So when there's a prolonged fasting, body thinks that you are in a fasting mode. So excess fat is burned, you know, for the caloric requirements of the body. To run the body, you need a calories continuously. When you sleep, then also our heart is functioning, your respiration is going on, our digestion process is going on. For that also, you need calories. So these excess calories are consumed from the fat. When there is no food in the tummy, these excess calories are consumed from the fat, which is there in the body. And so there is a gradual fat loss. So you should do, that is a concept of intermittent fasting. And also insulin is released only 2 times in a day if you have intermittent fasting, like in the lunch, during lunchtime and during dinner time. Only 2 times a day insulin is released. So that controls your blood sugar also beautifully. If this patient is pre-diabetic or early diabetic, And if she follows this pattern, there can be a reversal of diabetes, they are saying. Along with intermittent fasting, if anybody can avoid milk and milk products, that also helps in the reversal of diabetes. You know, many of my relatives and patients also, I advise them, you know, they're diabetic, to try this intermittent fasting, and it has helped them a lot for a good sugar control.
Yes, it is very popular among the diabetics. Madam, there is this question. Is PCOS similar to having fibroids?
No. PCOS is a hormonal problem. It's because of cycle irregularity, and it forms a cyst in the ovary. It's called polycystic ovarian disease. And fibroid is a muscle growth in the uterus. It's totally different. Yeah.
There is another query from Jyoti Kumari. Periods continue only for 2 days and the flow of blood is very low. Is this also a sign of and symptom of PCOS?
She gets regular periods. Periods are regular, she's saying.
Jyoti Kumari, if you would like to ask personally.
Hello?
No, period is actually irregular. I mean, 2 months of gaps are there, so...
And how much is the weight? Weight is okay for your height?
No, weight is also not okay.
So then get yourself investigated. No, it is better to do a simple sonography, pelvic sonography, and few hormonal tests and thyroid. Okay.
Blood test as well as the sonography.
So you can know the reason.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Madam, again, related with the flow, what is the normal flow? How many days? There is this question. Is the flow of 2 to 2.5 days in periods normal?
See, some patients, they used to get a less flow only from the beginning. You know, if there is a sudden pattern or the sudden change in the pattern of the flow, like previously she used to get 5 to 6 days normal flow and suddenly it reduces to 1-2 days, then you have to find out the cause. If since the beginning only she's getting regular periods with less flow, it's okay. It's okay for her. No issue. Yeah.
Now there is this question. How can a water cyst caused by PCOS be cured?
Water cysts, usually they are small in size, and you with your lifestyle changes, reducing weight also, they disappear. The cycles become regular. Some patients, they need hormonal treatment. You know, the cycles are irregular. They're going haywire. Then you need a 3 to 6 months of pills, hormonal tablets. So that regularizes the cycle, and then the cyst also automatically disappears, the regularization of the cycle.
There is this question. What is the difference between endometrics and PCODs or PCOS? Endometrics and PCOD.
Endometriosis is a condition in which normally what happens when the girl menstruates, her endometrium lining, which is covering the inside of the womb, it sheds from below, you know, it comes out from the vagina. That's a normal menstrual blood. Sometimes what happens is endometrial tissue, it goes from the uterus through the tubes into the abdomen and it implants on the ovaries or tubes or into the intestine. You know, that causes the problem. So that causes painful bleeding. You know, the patient starts bleeding from those spots also. Whenever this normal menstruation starts, from the uterus she bleeds, and from those endometrial tissue which are implanted outside the uterus on the ovaries or on the tubes, there also they bleed. So that causes adhesions or the sticking of the intestine to the uterus, to the tubes. So that causes very painful bleeding. You know, bleeding is, PCOD bleeding is not painful. But when it's endometriosis, patient starts getting pain 3 to 4 days in advance before her period starts, actually. And once the flow starts, the pain gradually disappears. That is a characteristic of endometriosis. Some patients, they get a lot of vomiting also, loose motions before the period starts. And once the flow starts, all these symptoms diminish. And then they get irregular bleeding. Like they bleed continuously throughout the cycle. Some patients, they get spotting. But it's very painful. It's totally different condition, endometriosis. Cannot confuse it with PCOD. It's totally different.
Ma'am, there is one question by... this person has said, I have been throwing up in connection with just what you said. I have been throwing up on the first day of period along with excruciating pain in the pelvic area, lower back and lower body. What
on,
is that?
On first day.
Yeah.
First day. Usually what happens, you know, in young girls, the uterus mouth is tightly closed, you know, cervix is tightly closed. So this is called as a primary dysmenorrhea. Means the uterus contraction happens when there is a heavy flow, like clots. When the clot come out, it causes pain. Because the uterine contraction, it causes pain. So this is typical of young girls, you know, once they get married or they bear children and then deliver, the uterus womb mouth becomes loose and then the pain also disappears. So this is different. This endometriotic pain, it happens before the period starts. You know, 4 to 5 days or 7 days also before the period starts, they start getting low pelvic pain. So throughout the cycle also, they get little pain here and there, body ache is there. So they are uncomfortable. They get frequency of urination also sometimes. Some patients, they get loose motion. Some patients get vomiting. This primary dysmenorrhea usually happens on the first day or second day of the period. And after taking painkiller, it subsides.
There are other questions which are generally related with the discomfort. So there's the pain in the back, the full body pains. There's a lot of pain in the stomach. I experience pain on my lower stomach. Is there any problem? I always have an issue of back pain and my full body pain during normal days too. And during periods, I have an issue of full body pain and pain on my lower stomach.
Achha, pain in the lower stomach can be relieved by taking a simple painkiller like Meptal. Meftal, she can take Meftal's pad or take a hot water fermentation to the tummy. And your bowel should be clear, you know. During menses, sometimes the patients are constipated. So if you take a laxative or increase your diet of the fiber intake should be more during this period. Eat a healthy diet as far as possible. Avoid junk food. So that will, I think, help with the problem. And you should take a calcium supplements if you're getting backache or body ache throughout the cycle. So that may be some other reason, you know, if you have the calcium and vitamin D deficiency, that may cause a body ache. So she should consult a doctor and start calcium and vitamin D supplements. That will help her.
Madam, there is this question. Whenever my period starts, it lasts for more than 15 days. And this problem started 1 year back.
Okay.
I visited a gynecologist and did homeopathic treatment, but nothing has helped.
So she visited a homeopathic?
Yeah.
She visited a gynec also. Then what was the diagnosis by gynec?
Pooja. Pooja, would you like to ask madam directly your question?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I visited a gynec and I did homeopathy also. I'm doing homeopathy right now, but it's not helping, ma'am. It started last May. And even right now, I'm bleeding.
What was the diagnosis? What was the diagnosis by gynec? Your sonography was done?
Sonography was done, ma'am.
So what she said?
She didn't say anything. She just gave me some medicines. And she said, I have PCOD.
You have a PCOD?
Yeah.
So she gave you a course of hormones?
Yeah.
So the hormones also you were bleeding or it was under control?
Ma'am, I don't know that.
Yeah? No, you took a course of hormones?
It was not a course, ma'am. It was just 1 month to stop the bleeding at that time. For that medicine she gave. And the next month, I should get my periods on time. So for that she gave. That's it. Okay. So there was no course or anything.
Yeah, you should take a course of medicines, you know, under doctor's supervision. Do hormonal tests also. Thyroid, prolactin levels and hormonal assays. No, okay. Find out the cause. Why are you getting this heavy?
I did some blood tests like LFS, FH, yeah. That all I did.
They're normal?
Yeah, that's all fine. But this, since last May, I've been facing this issue, ma'am. Achha. For 15-20 days, I bleed continuously and it's heavy.
It's heavy flow. I think you should respond to the hormonal treatment. You should take a proper treatment from the gynec.
Okay.
Respond to the hormonal treatment. You're taking iron supplements also, no?
Yeah.
You'll be anemic, no? If you bleed for a long time.
Yes, I do take.
Yeah. And if the flow is heavy, you can take a pause. It's called a tranexamic acid, you know, pause.
Yeah.
500, 3 times a day for 3 days. That will stop your heavy flow.
Okay, ma'am.
The iron supplements and consult a gynec, proper gynec.
I've been consulting her since last 12 years.
12 years? Achha, you're married? Yeah. You're married?
No. Ever since I started my periods, I've been having PCOD. Oh.
Achha. And what about your weight? Weight is okay?
My weight, yeah, it is fine. Like,
it is normal.
But I guess, yeah.
If you're overweight, try to reduce weight and change your life.
No, my height is 5'4 and my weight is 52, so it's like proper.
Okay, weight is proper. So the stress
is proper, yeah.
Probably
because I don't sleep on time.
Yeah, you're studying a lot.
Yeah.
Okay. So I think you should consult a gynec, you know.
Yeah. I'll have to change my gynec now.
Yeah, change the gynec.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, there is another question. Mm-hmm. Is white discharge a symptom of PCOS?
No. White discharge is not a symptom. White discharge indicates, some patients, they get a physiological leukorrhea, what is called. It's a normal leukorrhea. Young girls, they're anemic. They also get this white discharge. And during ovulation also, you get a little white discharge because the hormone increase. Like estrogen is the hormone which causes this excess white discharge, you know, which prepares the body for the ovulation. And after the ovulation, it is more watery during ovulation and then it thickens. It's because of the estrogen progesterone hormones. But if it's itchy, if the patient is getting a lot of itching or it's a foul smelling or it's a burning in the while passing urine, that indicates there is an infection. Then you have to treat it. So normal white discharge is there. You know, throughout the cycle, patients, they get little white discharge. That is normal. But if there is an itching, it's a soreness, foul smelling, then it needs a treatment. Or if it's yellow, curdy white, it needs a treatment.
Madam, there is one question which asks, is hot water bag better or cold ice pack to ease cramps?
Hot water bag is better.
Can Jyoti Vishwakarma has asked this question, can hypothyroidism result in PCOD?
Hypothyroidism, it can cause an increased weight gain and that can lead to PCOD. Hypothyroid patient, they are usually overweight. If it is not controlled, if thyroid is not controlled properly, it can lead to increased weight gain. That can result in PCOD.
Okay. Usma has asked this question, getting periods early by 3 to 4 days. For 3 to 4 months, is it normal?
3 to 4 days early, it is normal. So no need to worry. No need to worry. If the periods are not heavy, they have normal duration, moderate amount, it's okay. No need to worry.
Usma, has your question been, has it been answered? I mean, what do you mean by your 3 to 4 months? Would you like to ask yourself?
So the periods were getting, for the first month, it was 3 days earlier from the normal date. Then it was four days earlier in the second and the third month. So is it normal, ma'am, to get periods early this early?
3 to 4 days early is fine. If you're getting twice a month or in 10 and 15 days duration, then there's a problem. 3 to 4 days early is fine. There is nothing to be done for that. The flow is heavy or flow is normal?
Ma'am, it is normal.
Normal, no? No need to worry. Don't do anything. Just take iron supplements. You feel weak or tired, take iron supplements. Okay.
Yes. There is another interesting question. To participate in auspicious occasions, sometimes women take certain hormone tablets to delay the menses. Yeah. How safe is it to delay or prepone your date of menses?
See, once in a while, they can take, like once or twice in a year, they can take, you know. For the trivial reasons, nowadays these girls and women, they ask for these hormonal tablets. You know, if they attend a marriage or some party, you know, that is not right. If the religious function or if they are actively participating in that religious function, if they are sitting for puja or something like that, then it's okay. Otherwise, there is no need to prepone or postpone the periods.
Very good. There is this question, can PCOS affect pregnancy?
Yeah, see, PCOS, because of this irregular ovulation, there is a difficulty in conceiving. Once, this girl gets married and she tries for the pregnancy, she may need a little treatment for that, you know, for the ovulation to happen, she will need a treatment. So the lifestyle changes, weight loss, that also helps. Along with that, she will need a medication.
Right.
Certain medicines need to be given.
Actually, there are so many questions, ma'am. So many. Right now, while I am at a question, I can see 60 new messages below. And generally, there is a concern. Everybody has this concern. Is so many days enough Or I mean, the if we are menstruating for less days, is it a cause for concern? If we are menstruating for more days, is it a cause for concern? Here, there is one question. I bleed for more than 15 days. I visited the gynec and tried home treatment, but nothing helps. I have PCOD for the last 12 years. So maybe what way she can take relief is what she's asking.
See, the same thing, you know, the lifestyle changes, weight loss, stress reduction. I don't know, nowadays, that's what I'm telling, you know, ki, 3 out of 4 girls, you know, they are suffering from PCOS. You know, there is a sudden surge in these cases. This new generation. Like for my generation also, there were very few cases. But our daughters, I don't know why they are suffering. You know, mother is not suffering, but his daughters are suffering. So there is some kind of stress or irregular eating pattern. I don't know whether we give them a lot of the food to eat or they're hogging on junk food. That may be the reason. They're not eating home-cooked meals. You know, nobody is interested in eating home-cooked meals nowadays. Everybody wants to order from outside. So they have to change their lifestyle. They have to look within themselves. What is the reason why there is a sudden this problem, the hormonal changes in these young girls? No, and they have to take repeatedly hormonal treatment. You also get fed up. You know, I don't know how to treat these young girls. You know, you can't give the hormonal courses for a long duration of time. We give them for 3 months, 6 months. They're all right. And we advise them regarding diet and they follow for some duration. Then they stop. They again revert back to normal. And these girls, they are prone for depression also. They get sometimes they get panic attacks, you know, when the exams approach. They are into chronic stress. They get panic attacks. So there is some problem there psychologically also. They should be, I think they need a counseling, you know, these girls. They're very much worried of their menstrual pattern, you know, they keep a track, continuous track. And then they always have a complaint, I get less flow, more flow, you know, they're so much worried.
The moment they hear, actually, this is a human tendency. We start thinking, perhaps I am suffering from this. And then, you know.
Saying, you know, in general, see, 30-35 days cycle is okay. Even if it goes up to 40 days, it's okay. But since beginning, if she has that tendency, and if she bleeds for 2 to 3 days also, that is fine. But if the cycles are more than 2 months, and if she bleeds excessively, 10 to 15 days, then you should meet doctor. Otherwise, it is perfectly fine. No need to worry.
There is this another question. At what age is pap smear test advised?
See, pap smear, when the girl or woman becomes sexually active, we advise pap smear. So it depends, you know, nowadays this generation, the girls become active, you know, especially if they think they are sexually active, they should get their pap smear test done. Because pap smear is done to rule out cervical cancer. The cervical cancer is occurred because of HPV infection. And this HPV is human papilloma virus infection. It's a sexually transmitted disease. So that's why she becomes sexually active, whatever may be the age, you know, young girls, 16, 17, then they should get this pap smear test done if she's sexually active. If she's not sexually active, after marriage, she should get it done after 35 years of age. They can do it on the regular basis. And they should take that vaccine, which is available now for the cervical cancer, you know. 3 doses vaccine. From 10 to 45 age group, all females, they should take that vaccine. That gives you lifelong protection. If you take it early, it is better. Immune response is better.
There is this question. Sometimes I get an issue with white discharge and I experience excess white discharge. Sometimes there's a change in color, yellowish or brownish. Is there a serious problem? Though you mentioned it earlier, but...
Yeah, it can be because of infection. So yellow or brownish. It can be a little infection. Some girls, they have a hygiene issue also. You know, during the period, they should change their pads more frequently. You know, as far as possible, at night also, you should change the pad. And during periods, they can use some wash, you know, like vaginal wash product, you know, lactic acid vaginal wash product they can use to maintain the hygiene. And if they are sexually active, they should take a proper precaution. Barrier contraception should be used, like condom, you know, because they're sexually active. That can transmit the diseases.
Right.
They should be aware of that.
There is this question by Nicey. Can ultrasound sonography help in determining how healthy our ovaries are or there is a defect in the organ? And would you, I mean, should one really go for, you know, and
routine ultrasound in young girls?
Yeah, sonography.
No, if everything is fine, the cycles are regular, there is no need to do. She's getting irregular cycles, then you should do. But as the age advances, like the patient is trying to become pregnant, gets married, then she should do, before conceiving, she should do, get one ultrasound done. To rule out not just ovaries, but any other pathology in the uterus, like any fibroid is there, or ovary cyst is there, not just PCOD, any ovary, simple ovary cyst also will be diagnosed. And so before trying to conceive, she should rule out any pathology.
There is another question. Can PCOS happen after pregnancy or having kids?
Yes, it can happen at any time. Any time. Throughout her life, it can happen. Before the menopause, in menarche and menopause, it can happen any time. Sudden hormonal changes can cause PCOS. Sudden weight gain, stress level increases. That can cause PCOD.
Excessive blood clots, is it normal during periods?
Excessive blood clots indicate that there is an excessive endometrial lining. It means lining is thick, endometrial lining. So when this sheds, this it comes in the form of a blood. So when there's excess blood clot, that means there is a heavy flow. Some patients, they are used to get this heavy flow for the first day of the cycle. It is normal. But if it remains for 2 to 3 days, it is with painful, big clots are passing. That means there's excess blood flow. So they should take medicines to reduce their blood flow and find out the cause why she's getting excess.
That means medical intervention is required. Do we have to get ovaries removed if the number of cysts increase in the ovaries?
No. You have to first find out the cause why there are ovarian cysts. You know, if there are benign cysts, there are simple cysts, with hormonal treatment, they will resolve. If anybody is suspecting cancerous growth, then you have to investigate for that. You have to do certain tests to find out what is the cause. Just you should not remove the ovaries like that. During near menopause also, we don't remove. The patient has to undergo hysterectomy. You know, why, for any other reason, we don't remove the ovaries. You know, even if the patient is 50 years old, we try to preserve the ovaries. You know, because the ovaries, whatever hormone is produced, even after the menopause, that is good for the bones. You know, because otherwise, the patient will end up in osteoporosis. So we don't remove the ovaries like that. You have to find out if there is any pathology, genuine pathology, then only you remove the ovaries. Otherwise, don't touch the ovaries.
There is this question, naturally manipulating your menstrual cycle is okay sometimes, like taking sugarcane juice or coconut water?
I don't know whether it really helps to manipulate the cycle. I don't know. You know, they think some heaty food they will have. No, they had papaya. You know, if they want to prepone their period, they will have papaya, 2 to 3 papayas in a day. And if nothing happens, they will have the sugarcane juice and then they will come to me. I still have not got the period. Then give me some hormonal tablets. I don't think it
is. Ma'am, to me, papaya isn't working, but sugarcane juice helps me like sometimes. And even coconut water helps. Okay. So is it okay like to do it very rarely?
Yes, you can have it. No issue.
Yeah, thank you.
There is this request. Madam, can you repeat about the vaccination? I think the vaccination that you spoke about for the
cervical cancer.
Yeah, cervical cancer.
In young girls who are not sexually active, they can take it directly. Vaccine, there are 3 doses. There are 2 companies now, Cervarix and Gardasil. They have a different immunization schedule, but both have 3 doses. You know, 1 dose today, another second dose after a month, and 3rd dose after 5 months. So it's a 6 months. Over the period of 6 months, you have to take 3 vaccines. So that gives a lifelong protection between the 10 to 45 year age group. So 10-year-old girl also, she can take a vaccine. 10 to 15 year, the young girl, less than 15 years, she can take only 2 vaccines. 2 doses are sufficient. Beyond 15 years, 15 to 45, they have to take 3 doses. So that gives a good protection. And you should take a rubella vaccine also. You know, before you get married, it's better to take a rubella vaccine. You know, the rubella is an infection which happens during the patient gets pregnant, then she has to terminate the pregnancy. It is very harmful to the growing fetus. So rubella vaccine is a must. It's MMR. It's called MMR, measles, mumps and rubella, which is routinely given during a childhood. But some patient, they misses that vaccine. Then you have to take that rubella vaccine before you try for the pregnancy.
All right. Yeah, now I think there have been quite a few questions. There have also been questions like, I have pimples that come up during the periods, and then a question like, how do you increase the height? So, madam, they have found a person in whom they can very safely, you know, ask all their questions and get satisfactory answers. So maybe they can even personally, there is another person who has said, how do I get in contact with you? How can I think she wants to know how she can consult you. Shifa. So yes, madam, we would like to share your, with your permission, your...
Ma'am, what do we do about it? Should we share your mobile number or this is already they can go on the website and get the address, Shushrut Hospital, but we have put that much. Shushrut Hospital.
Shushrut Hospital. So, you can give a mobile. Yeah. If she goes on the website, all numbers are there.
So yes, they all are there because I also got the details from there.
Vaishali ma'am, would you like to take up anything that has been left out? Any question that has been left out?
Yeah. Let's first ask Dr. Duple, madam, because I know your clinic time, your hospital time, because your last time you had shared that, okay, I can wait till 5 o'clock because you have to go for your hospital. This also, patients must be waiting for you. So is it okay? Maybe one or two questions more?
Yeah. You can ask.
Or we stop here.
No problem. You can continue.
I think there were questions related people using V wash frequently, V wash and all. So is it fine if we use V wash on a regular basis?
No.
And another question is many people end up taking. And another question was like we end up taking tablets. Which to delay our menses because we have Ganpati festival or weddings. So we take tablets. So is it fine? Can we take those kind of tablets or are they harmful to us?
Yeah, as I said earlier, once or twice in a year is okay, you know, but for trivial reasons, the patients take this tablet. That is not good, you know, because it disturbs your menstrual cycle. For the next 2 to 3 cycle, it gets disturbed. You know, so it is not advisable to take it on a regular basis. And regarding V-wash, you should not use it on regular basis. Like every day, there is no need to use V-wash. Only thing is that don't wash with water every time when you urinate. There is no need. You know, that causes drying of the skin. Don't wash with water. Only after passing motion, you should clean with water. Otherwise, there is no need to wash with water whenever you pass urine. That causes fungal infection. There is no need. Just clean with this, and after having any like during period, she can use this hygiene products, V-wash and all, or after sexual activity, intercourse, she can use to keep the area clean. Otherwise, there's no need.
I think Manjeet madam, most of the questions are answered. Lot of questions, and I'm curious, rather, ma'am, even you must have felt that lot of queries related to reproductive health and issues related, this young girls. I think we have covered almost all the questions, Manjeet madam.
Yeah.
Yes,
practically. Ma'am? Yeah. Just maybe a few may have been left out, which I think.
Ma'am, yes. There was one question I had read that is PCOS and fibroids the same or there is a difference between fibroids and PCOS?
Fibroids is the condition of the ovary. You know, there are, because of the irregular menstruation, there are cysts in the ovary. It is totally different from the fibroids. Fibroids is the muscle growth in the uterus. That is totally different.
That question has been addressed by me.
Okay. I was just looking at maybe... go back. I think we can stop.
We can now conclude the session.
Yes.
Because it's time for madam also. For patients are waiting for
her. Yes, please, Manjeet ma'am. Yes.
Dr. Maitri Dhople, it was such an eye opener today when you said that it has become a gynec epidemic, the PCOS.
Yeah.
And earlier you used to see 10 patients. In a month, and today you see 10 patients of PCOS in a day. And while you spoke to us in the beginning, you explained the process of ovulation, the causes of PCOS, sudden surge that we are seeing. It could be genetic, it could be the sedentary lifestyles, And especially the use of plastics and chemicals, the way they have increased in our lives today.
Yeah.
You also spoke about its diagnosis, sonography, and the other battery of tests that one should undergo to be able to come to a sound diagnosis of this disorder. And then you spoke about change in lifestyles, the diet and the exercise that people should embrace so that they can reduce the symptoms and the difficulties and the physical stress and strain that they face because of the PCOS. Madam, you have very nicely thrown light on every aspect and so patiently answered all the questions. And we could see the comfort level of our students, the way they have posted their questions. You know, they've just opened their heart and posted all their questions. Sorry if any of your questions were not able to take
up. I'm also very happy, you know, to answer all these questions. And these are genuine concerns of the students, you know.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So thank you very much. Thank you very much, madam, for being with us today, spending this precious time with us, giving us more insights on how to deal with this. And thank you all participants for all your questions. And in case we have not been able to ask any of your questions, as Vaishali madam said, we would be sharing madam's details with you, and you can definitely get in touch with madam. So on
behalf, I'll be very happy, you know, to any kind of help, you know, in the future also.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. So on behalf of
Vedanta
Research Society's Hansraj Jeevandas College of Education, our principal, Dr. Anita Swami, and the entire JCE team, I extend a heartfelt gratitude, madam, for being with us and sharing your precious time. Thank you so much once again, and we look forward to meeting with you again in future.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, dear.
Thanks a lot, madam. And we are putting up the feedback link. So please, filling up the feedback form is essential for procuring your e-certificate. So do fill up the feedback link that would be posted on the group. Okay, with this, we end the session. Thank you.